here in my garage to build another motorcycle helmet thing here.
We got all the good stuff here. Tape, things, bolts, fur. Gotta have fur. And yes, it's a variant. I know, the helmet every moto vlogger uses. I always give people crap for them because everyone and their mom runs them, but there's a good reason why. You're gonna get to that soon. But first things first, a word from our sponsor. Vikings. War of Knights. So this is like a Viking game. It's like one of those strategy games. Kind of like an old board game from back in the day, but of course it's now, you know, on the phone, 3D, in your pocket, you're playing with over 3 million people play this. That's what makes this game more fun. You gotta get on there and get to play with a group of people. I'm only trying to do a battle one time, I got whooped, but this game is pretty addicting so far. You got your little village here, you're gonna build it up, you're gonna fight other people, it's a lot of fun. There's all kinds of strategy games in the App Store, but this one's about Vikings. Now I'm just playing it here. Forgot what I'm doing already. Be sure to check them out. There's a link in the description. If you download from that link, you'll get 200 of these gold coin things, which are... I've already gone through my 200. I need more. There. Stay there. It was, what, like 6-7 months ago I built this helmet right here. Put these crazy fins on here, and I thought it looked cool because it had a big owl thing on the front. I guess I'm the only one who likes it. Everyone does. It's a cool helmet, man. It's got the old visor in there. I really like that stuff. But I did a setup video on this, and right after doing that setup video, I ended up changing things on it, and I always wanted to kind of give you guys an update video and explain what I was running after that, but I was never satisfied with it, and let me just get to it real quick. The ultimate problem I have with this helmet, what I always kind of had a problem with, when you run a normal full face shield, closed-in helmet, there's just not a lot of room for the microphone and one of these in there. This is the Sina mic for the Bluetooth communicator. If you go back and you watch that setup, it is a good setup. It's essentially what we're going to be putting in this one. But the problem is, when you go to put the helmet on, because it's so close and you're trying to fit the microphones in there, they tend to bump your nose. The thing I found with helmets like this, you can put the mic behind the cheek pad and you won't have that problem, but you're just not going to get as good a sound. This setup that I'm going to show you here, I know from running other dual sport helmets that got a little more room in the front, will have room for the mics. You just got to get some fluff around it, which is what this comes into. Well, show you more of that when we get there. What I had switched to is this Sina GP10 backpack. What this does is this Bluetooths the GoPro to your Bluetooth unit there. And it's kind of cool because it'll feed the audio right into the GoPro here. It also will let your buddy, if he's talking to you, if you guys are linked up, his audio will come through as well, so it's really cool for dual vlogging. You gotta use their case. A lot of people see this case in the videos and they say, what is that GoPro you're running? It's just a GoPro in a Sina case. That's where you get that kind of odd looking case there. But issues with this setup, the reason I never really made a video on it, is as great as it is for convenience, vlogging with your buddies, having a wireless, basically waterproof setup, I never thought the audio was that great. It just kind of does this really great job of isolating most every noise but your own voice. You can really get better audio from just running a mic like I'm going to show you out here today if you got room for it. But what I want to do is I want to be able to run both setups. So most of the time it's just going to be running off an actual mic like we did before, but I still want to be able to use this. And I've got a way to do that. I'm going to use this in my B camera, which I always run on my handlebars on my bikes, and I'll have that option in editing to add in somebody else's voice. We'll get to that though in a minute. To start with, I think I'm gonna put this Sina, it's the Sina extra clamp for the side, because I already have a 20S, there's no reason to buy an entire another one. You can just spend 50 bucks, I believe, is about what this cost, and just get one of these. So let's start with that. It comes with like extra microphones in there, and like, they give you a lot of extra. You got multiple options. You don't have to clamp this onto the helmet. That's what I'm gonna do. I like to run the clamp style, but you have a stick-on option in here too. I'm gonna take this helmet apart a little bit. They give you this little key thing here, and I believe you're supposed to just kind of... All right.
You know, I don't have one of those cool donuts like Anthony from Revzilla, but I do have a old Grom tire and a towel.
Anthony, dude, Revzilla here.
Blew that tire out, by the way, if you're wondering why it looks like that when I had my Grom. Look at that.
Perfect. Right.
What I like to do, this is the boom mic piece here. I like to actually run this style one and then bend it into the area that I want it at, because this also makes a really great place to add our other microphone. It's already got some fuzz on it, and I'll explain that in a minute, but we're actually just gonna electrical tape and zip tie that right to this existing boom mic. So we need to get it to where it's kind of, this part will have enough room to get up in here into the helmet. Take this this little wedge here, we want to get it between the foam liner and the outer part of the shell here. It's kind of a tight fit. A bit of particular, and you get it in there. Having the Bluetooth communicator, like I said, not only can you use that Cena piece if you want to get a buddy's audio in, then you make phone calls, listen to music, before we crank this down 100%, so make sure that's in a good position. Test fit this on here, make sure there's room. Yep, a lot of people I know, they'll put this on their helmet and they can't get it back off once it's on there. Kind of evenly space it down. There's these little fabric spots almost right over where your ear holes go, your ear holes. And they almost just Velcro right to this. See, there's a Velcro on the back here, and this is like a Velcro already kind of on here. I don't know if they did that intentionally for these or what. You are gonna have to snip a little piece of this plastic edge out here for these wires. What you wanna do is you wanna kind of half put this back together. Putting this cheek pad back in will be a little bit of a pain now with this piece in here, but so we're just kind of half getting it in place. Okay, we've lined this up, and what I can see here is where these wires right now are gonna align with the helmet piece. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna mark the spot where these wires are sitting on this plastic right here. Right in this area, right here. I put a slit right there. Before I stick that back together though, I'm gonna stick these speakers where I think those should go. And once the liner's in here, of course, it'll help hold it in. They're just both sitting in there. One's there, one's there. Make sure your wires are going in that little cut you made. Here, you wanna push it all the way down where it's getting behind that rubber seal right there. This folds over it. Really, you should be putting the back liner in first, but I just wanna make sure that's fitting good. Okay, like I said, that Velcro really puts the speaker right here in this, where's the other one so I can show you? Puts it right behind this piece in the cheek pad, which there's room for it right there. Thank you, icon, I guess. No, I need a haircut, it's happening soon. Oh, I'm kicking the camera, what am I doing there? The ear places where I put those speakers, the little places they put the Velcro, perfect, dude. My ears are not touching the speakers at all. There's no weird pressure. It's good, man. Microphones. Oh, yeah, it's got a little distance from my face. That's why these dual sports are so much better. Did I ever really explain the problem? Basically, my face kept bumping the mic every time I put the helmet on, and it would move it around slightly, and I would get different audio constantly. It would come right up under my nose or just somewhere else. That's why these dual sports style helmets are so preferred by motovloggers, realistically. It's because they have enough room to fit this speaker as well as the Cena one. Well, that part's done. The next, get the GoPro mounted, then we can worry about the GoPro audio. I remember Accidental Broadcast used to run his stuck. Actually, it was upside down with a magnet up here. You used to glue a magnet. I can't do that, man. I'm gonna do a style that I did on my last dual sports helmet, kind of like this, and I'm gonna run it sort of an off-center right here. Not directly in the front, not off to the side, banging in the trees like B-Rad did. I'm gonna get it right here, and I really like that setup because it's kind of just enough into your line of sight that you can see when this thing's running or not. I like to use the one button start, the quick start, and you just tap it once, the whole thing fires on. It's just enough into your line of sight where you can see the LEDs turn on. This is a silver, so I got the whole back lights up. The new fives all have that screen too, and it's on for just about 5 seconds and turns off. It's enough that you can visually tell, oh yeah, my GoPro's running. And of course, the camera, I like to run the lens to this way, not out here, so it's getting pretty close in line with your line of sight. I also really like having it up front like this so you don't get any helmet in the shot. It's kind of a cool aspect having it off to the side, seeing it, but it also blocks part of the shot. So I went out and got a new thing of GoPro mounts here. One of the few things I'll actually make for certain I'm buying GoPro brand up, just so I know I'm getting the proper 3M adhesive on there, not some knockoff stuff. Don't know if I'm gonna run a flat or a curved yet. Yeah, the curved one's gonna be the one we're gonna go with. Before you stick these down, you gotta really sort of figure out what setup you're gonna run. I got this thing off the Amazon machine here. It's aluminum, gives you a little bit more flexible options there without having to have 15, 20 little arms on there. I grabbed me a new housing. Again, these, you know, I got this one off Amazon. It's much cheaper than the actual GoPro brand one. It's got a good rating. That's what I was like, do y'all like to go see what the rating is? It's got a good rating, I'm not really worried about it. Oh yeah, there you go. You got your little skeleton hole in the side there. That's really cool, it came with that. I think we'll be able to get the manipulation that we're looking for out of this. Rub an alcohol here, make sure it's super clean before we put this down. I was gonna show y'all a trick. I'll explain it because I don't think I'm gonna have to do it, but what I've done in the past, if there's too much contouring going on in the helmet here and I don't think I can get a good seal with the piece there, I'll actually cut some small strips of this. This is actually just 3M double-sided, and I'll make like little layers. You gotta trim them out real small, you make little layers, you peel off both sides, and you stick them in there to try to fill it in and be a flat area. Here, for example, here on my old one, I'm using a curve mount, but it's got a little bit of gaps on the two ends where it didn't quite seal in. So what there is, and it's hard to even see it so well squished in there, but there's a couple little strips of that 3M on the sides. Smash it all down, and it's not going anywhere. As you can see, I can hold the helmet by the mount. This one's touching so much, I'm really not that worried about it. Peel this off and full commit. Really touched it. It was just really. Don't like to give up once they start touching down. I'm supposed to give these like 24 hours to dry, but as you can see here, I'm already holding the helmet by the mount. These things are, they're pretty damn good once you get them on. Replace all of these little arms with some Allen's heads just to make it a little bit cleaner looking. To make the whole mount much smaller looking, it's something about like that. I'm gonna start snugging these down. You don't wanna crank them on the helmet. I'll explain that here in a second. And before you completely commit, you gotta figure out your audio cable. You see, it's just barely going up here. I'll explain this audio cable here while I'm setting this up the rest of the way. This is the, you know, the mic adapter for the 3s and 4s. My mic adapter's got that 90 degree in it. It's a real hit or miss whether those things will work when you see one on Amazon, or they do work at all. They usually only give sound through one speaker. This one actually works and works in stereo. It's only a few bucks. I'll put the link to it. Like I said, it's such a crapshoot knowing if you're getting one that works or not. That one works. I will put the link to it. All right, at this point, I've gotten all my little arms in the position that I want them. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take it off to really crank these down. The reason why is because you try to do it on here and you can pop this mount off when you start torquing down on these. So this is a good time to try to do it in your hand. Try not to let it move when you're doing this, of course. A setup like this, I don't plan to change this. If I'm gonna put another GoPro setup on a different helmet, I'll just buy all this stuff right here. Like I said, this is usually the most expensive part if you buy the GoPro one, you know, a new case. I'll buy all of it, because I'll buy this one off Amazon, I think it was 12 bucks or something. And it's built really nice. Anyway, see there, I've got all my arms super tight now. This thing, it's solid. And I've done it so that the clip is running backwards. If I'd done it the other way, I wouldn't be able to get it in here once these were all tight. But because it's like this, I can walk up to it, snap it in. That's perfect. It's right there. I can just barely see it. It doesn't actually obstruct my vision, but is it straight though? Is it got a little lean? I can fix that. Good news and bad news. The good news is I got me a Sonic ice cream thing from the ice cream man. The bad news is the main camera died, so I have to use a GoPro. For some reason, all my batteries are dead. I charged them all up the other day. I guess I gotta get better ones. I don't know. Like I said, sorry we're on the GoPro camera, but we're almost done here. The only part we have left to do is add the microphone. Now, I ripped off that foam I had on it before. Yeah. Now, I'm gonna do something a little bit different between ideas. Oh, it's my neighbor's electric mower. This is straight up an idea I've stolen from Ian187. I'm gonna be running this fabric-y foam stuff. This is like some fake fur you can get. We're gonna put a square of that inside the helmet right behind the microphone. It's gonna act like a dead cat, if you will. I went to the local fabric store and told them I wanted the smallest amount of this I could get. And this is, you know, this is about what you end up with. We're gonna use some of that 3M adhesive I was talking about before to stick it on. So what we wanna do here, I got kind of this inside area right here where the mic's going to be sitting. I don't think we're going to need a ton of this stuff because, where is it at? We've got this little chin skirt that it comes with. I'm going to stick in there, which should help. Should help block a lot of the wind as is. All right, so this is always fun trying to cut this stuff here. You almost have to try to comb it over, or you're going to end up with it. You're gonna end up with this stuff everywhere regardless. And I'm gonna tell you right now, because people always ask, don't you get the fur in your mouth? You're gonna have to give it a little bit of a haircut when you're done. All right, this little thing is gonna see how little bits are coming off here. So that's a little square we've made. I think what I'm gonna do is situate that right up in here. And it seems to stick to this pretty good. I mean, I've never had this like try to come off. I've stuck it a little bit on the backside here. I know I'm gonna stick that right up into here. I'm gonna peel these off. You gotta try not to let this fabric come back around and get onto there. Sorry, I know I'm doing this where you guys can't see it as well, but just, I think you get what I'm doing right now. There it is. Not too many people can say they have to give their helmets a haircut. It's almost doing this motion inside there.
because I want to make a place for this microphone sit right up against it there. This microphone, by the way, is another one that Ian187 suggested to get. Works pretty well. It's a stereo mic, which inside your helmet I think is in no way necessary. I'm going to twist this around a couple times. Paper down there. Said it's a good microphone for these motovloggings, but it does have that stereo issue to it, which kind of complicates it slightly because it's not just a straight mic going in. You gotta sort of think how you're putting it in there. All right, let's sandwich that up in there. You gotta kind of fluff your fluff up here. Just stick this in. Make sure the microphone's kind of buried into it.
Microphone's pretty much just sandwiched into all that fluff right now. You can see it a little bit better from the top view.
Got the mic pulled tightly right here. For right now, we'll just leave this cable here. We're gonna address that in a second, but I'm gonna go ahead and stuff this piece on there. I don't think it's 100% necessary. What I'm showing you should block enough wind that it's not a problem. Like I said, I ran my other dual sport helmet with no visor on at all, like actually running it like a dirt bike helmet and not had it have terrible wind noise or anything like that. Microphone is right here in relation to my nose. Yeah, that's good. It's not right under. I've got this cable right here and I already have this little area we've cut in the plastic here to run the cables for the Cena through. I'm actually gonna run the mic cable into the same little hole right there.
I had to stop. I was getting like pelted by June bugs as if they're being shot out of a cannon into my face.
Sprouts up across the boom mic here and then, there we go, pops in right there with the rest of the wires.
I kind of went ahead a little bit while I was waiting. It's real simple though. The mic cable basically goes up and around through the liner. And then what I've done here, this is where it comes out on the other side. Just barely see it right there coming up. And what we've got here is a little bit of tape holding the wire into place. This is actually like gaffing tape or non-stick duct tape, and you get in black. I like this stuff because this could sit on there for a long time and it doesn't leave residue. It's a really good kind of tape to use for this stuff. I know it looks a little crummy having to have tape on there, but at least it's black, it kind of blends in. I mean, usually there's always a little bit of stuff like that, but ultimately from the outside, things look pretty clean. I gotta make for sure, you know, these things are gonna work before you bolt all this down. And I was pretty tight on this almost not fitting. So here's the GoPro right here. You gotta be able to get the GoPro out when this is all tightened up in the position you're gonna run it in, right? So if we open this back door up here, the GoPro can just barely, it's in there though. So we put that in there, close that up. And then if you'd put this piece on the other way, you'd have a problem right now because you wouldn't really be able to get in there and lock it in properly, but it comes in from the front, lock it in. And what you have to do there is you have to get it all put together like this before you really route this audio cable. That duct taping I did there, I'm kind of going out of order slightly, sorry. But you gotta sort of manipulate and play with it, pull your slack up on the cable to get it as clean as you can. And what you end up with is this cable right here. The setup ends up being fairly clean in my opinion. You just got the little wire coming around like that. Won't snag on anything. And just kind of comes around here through the back side. You can kind of see the red LEDs here from the side of your helmet. You'd be able to see that LED screen running there for a minute. Let's go test it out though, see if it works worth the damn. I think I'll take the FZ because that one's still in full knobby mode. And I've been told the FZ's slightly louder. That'll be a better test.
All right, here we are. Tap the button once, and then she's on. Of course, we need to switch over to this audio.
I can run the audio off of this if I got a buddy who's talking with me and I want to get his audio, but most of the time I think I'm going to be sticking off the audio off of this. Here we go. I'm talking with my normal voice. These are the things you got to do when you're testing out your microphone. Fairly windy. Uh-oh. Need gas. We're going 60. Let's open the visor. See what kind of audio we get. What's up, buddy?
The noise level hasn't picked up a bunch, but I don't know what the mic is experiencing right now. I like to do things though like this when I'm testing it out.
Just ride it with it open for a bit, ride it with it closed for a bit, talk with a really loud voice.
Talk with a really quiet voice.
Make it different. I'll stop that now, I'm sorry. Talking in this direction, or this direction, or this direction, or this direction, change the audio. Sometimes it does. Nice to know. I wonder if y'all hear that. Blah, 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 blah. It always, like, kind of gargles and bangs as it revs down, connects to this wall here. Sounds really good. Let's park up here. I'll park by the tree, not the trash can. That seems more appealing. B camera, if you're not gonna, you know, run this whole Cena thing, you could run, I think, one of those GoPro knockoffs. I'd make sure it's got the super wide angle view, because this is running, both these are running what's called super view. I think it's just great. It gives a really tall aspect this way. I mean, it distorts the image a bit more, as you can imagine it will. There's no way to avoid that. So I'm going to run home and test this out. If it's good, I guess this is the end of the video. If not, we'll tinker some more. But thanks for joining me on this. I will put all the links to all the stuff that I'm using in the description. It's little pink flowers. My little girl loves these. We go for walks, and these all grow around my neighborhood. Go, flower, flower. She always wants to go grab one. Let's give some muff sounds to end the video. She's a good one. That's a real nice sound of pop you got on your back there, mister. I know. Y'all take care.